I'm in mourning, y'all. It's a sad day in Georgia. It's a sad day in Georgia. Because the Bulldogs lost. And we wanna take a time to mourn their loss. So today, let's just take a moment of silence for Georgia. Is a good pound cake and a nice fudgy brownie. But today we're gonna keep it simple and quick as we always do. We're gonna make it foolproof, baby, so can't nobody mess this up. Baby, your dog will be able to make this cake because it's so easy. All right, so let's get to the tutorial, y'all. It's all the ingredients down below in the description box, okay? Because I ain't got time for this video to be like 30 minutes long. We're gonna need a bowl. I'm using the red bowl today because y'all know crimson and cream is the color of Bama, and I ain't got no crimson bowl, so I'm gonna use the red bowl, okay? So you gotta get it a large bowl, because you wanna make sure all your ingredients can fit into this bowl. Then what we're gonna do is, we're gonna go ahead and make, I've already made the brownie batter mix. I use a box brownie mix, and I just follow the directions. That's all you got to do. But make sure that you get the fudgy brownie, okay? And don't make your brownies like cake brownies. Make them like fudgy brownies, okay? You want it to be fudgy, so when we put in this batter, honey, all that fudge and all that gooiness gonna be up in this pound cake, and it's gonna be good as hell. And that's what we want it to be, okay? So just get you a box of brownies at the Walmart, or at Target, or wherever you wanna shop, and follow the directions. We're gonna have our eggs, and we have our butter flavor shortening. I will list all of the ingredients in the description. All of my ingredients are room temperature. You wanna do that to make sure that you always set your eggs out, set your cream out, all that stuff. Make sure all of your ingredients are room temperature, okay? We're gonna start with our bowl. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to first start with our sugar. I'm gonna pour that in there, okay? And then I'm gonna put our butter in there. And we're gonna cream the butter and the sugar together. I'm about to do the butter, the sugar, and the butter flavor shortening. Butter flavor shortening, y'all, is so important. I use butter flavor shortening in all of my cakes. That's why they be good and buttery and delicious. And everybody be like, girl, what you put in that cake? And I don't tell them nothing. But I'm telling y'all today. So for all my ladies out there trying to get a man, you know, a man loves a good pound cake, child. Okay? It's a man cake. It's a hearty cake. And this cake is going to be delicious because of this secret ingredient right here, butter flavored shortening. So I'm putting it all in there. And the measurements will be in the description box below. So don't worry. We're going to cream all this together. That's cream together, we're gonna start with our eggs. Now I use salted butter, honey, when I bake, okay? Cause y'all know I like some seasoning. I need flavor stocked up in there. And let me tell you something, a teaspoon of salt goes a long way, or salt goes, a little bit of salt goes a long way in a cake, y'all. I promise you, I have made cakes before and I have forgot that pinch of salt. And baby, my cakes has been trash, baby. People talked about me, okay? But like, oh, she thought that cake was good, but it was bland as hell. No, so to have a little insurance, I always just use salted butter because it knocks it all out and it puts it all in there. That way I don't forget with my crazy self, okay? What I did was I put all my eggs into a mug, because what you wanna do is you wanna crack your eggs in a separate bowl because you wanna beat them, you don't wanna beat them all together. Okay, and it also, if you crack it in a separate bowl, you get to see if you get a bad egg. Now crack your eggs in there, and we're gonna go. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and beat the eggs in, and I'm going to alternate it with my cake flour as well. Okay, it's swan's down. I'm using this because this is what my mama used, this is what my grandma used, this is what her mama used, and I ain't, if it ain't broke, don't try to fix it. Let me tell you a little secret. I know somebody gonna probably say something, but I don't care. Let me tell you something. I do not sift my cake flour. Let me tell you, I had the best pound cake before for my ex-boyfriend, mine. But I always ask her how your cakes turn out so moist and just dense and just delicious. And when I saw her make her cakes, she never ever sifted her cake mix. So after that, her cake flour. I don't sift my cake flour. It's already sifted. And so she told me that's what to do, and that's what I've been doing. And baby, let me tell you something. My cakes turn out amazing. And plus, I ain't got time. And let me tell you, this is how I do it. So I ain't changing it. Now, if you want to sift your flour, that's totally fine. But baby, I ain't had no problems. I don't sift my cake flour. Miss Barbara told me don't sift it, and her cakes be amazing. Okay, so that's what I've been doing for a couple years now. And honey, it saved me time, stress, and it still be good as hell. A hand mixer. I do have a KitchenAid, but I realize a lot of y'all ain't got that out there. Okay, y'all got a hand mixer because KitchenAid be $199 and up. So a lot of y'all don't have that. But people be always be like, oh, I ain't got no KitchenAid or I don't have a stand mixer. What can I use? A hand mixer. It's still gonna be good. So I want to whip this cake up with the hand mixer just to show you guys just how good it would be even if you don't have a stand mixer. Okay. So what I got right now is I got a bundt pan. Now, you can use a tube pan, you can use whatever you want, but I suggest you use a pan with the little holes in there or whatever. You know, that's what we normally use for pound cakes, little bundt pan. So, what you wanna do is make sure that you grease your pan really good. Now, mostly, I'm saying grease it, like they get greased, like you get greased up before. I mean, like you finna beat up LaQuisha that's coming to your house for trying to take your man. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want you to get greased, you gotta grease this thing up like you about to get ready to fight, okay? That's what you wanna do to make sure that your cake don't stick, okay? Cause what the worst thing is, okay, putting it in your pan and it don't come out right. Which means I'm saying that when you flip this pan over, it don't come out, it be stuck. Don't nobody want that, okay? You did all this hard work, spent your good hard money at the grocery store, okay? So make sure you grease it. But I got a little something for you just in case you don't know how to, okay? What my mama like to use all that. Now you can use easy, take some butter and put it in the pan or whatever and do that. That's how my grandma and them used to do or whatever. But this baker's drawer right here, it already has the flour in it and also the grease or whatever you need so that your cake don't stick in this pan. I swear by it, my mama swear by it, my aunties, everybody swear by it. So baker's joy is what you wanna use. We're gonna spray it real good. I mean, spray it like you about to mist your face and set your foundation. Spray it real good, and then we're gonna get the batter in the pan, and I'm gonna put the brownie mix in there. I'm gonna show you how to do it. Okay, you wanna spray this thing like you wanna get the edges and everything. I mean, just like a good weave, okay? That's what you wanna do. You wanna spray it real good, just like that. And baby, my pan is beat up and good, and that's how you know your cake gonna be good as hell. Got a little few scratches up in there. That's how you know your cake gonna be good, okay? So this is how we grease our pans, y'all. Make sure you get, you gonna snatch them edges with grease like a lace front, baby. That's what you wanna do, all right? So now we're gonna put the batter in. So we're gonna pour half the mixture in. Well, not even half the mixture, okay? So what we're gonna do, we're gonna pour it in just like this. And y'all gonna watch me do this, okay? You always want to hit your cake a couple of times. This is going to get the air out of the cake, okay? Keeps the cake from drying out, all right? Just like that. Then we're going to bake it on 325 for about an hour and 20 minutes, y'all. So I was thinking to myself, I said, man, self, myself said, I said, now this cake needs a little bit some extra now. On top now, we just can't have the cake. What else would be good as hell on this cake? And I said, you know what would be good? A cream cheese glaze. So, while the cake is baking, what we gonna do, y'all, we gonna make a cream cheese glaze go on top. true. I've got a towel here. Got some sugar on it, but that's okay. And what you want to do is you want to take a plate or a cake plate. I found this at Marshall's and Ross. Marshall's and Ross is my favorite place to shop, y'all. This is about $10. And or if you don't have that, baby, you can use a paper plate. I don't care. Just get the cake out. What you want to do is make sure you grip the back of this, of your cake plate or your cake. Make sure that is secure. And then I have my hand tucked right here. And we're just going to flip it over just like that, y'all. Boom! Look at that. Do you see those chunks of brownie in there, y'all? And we ain't even cutting to this bad boy. And you already see how amazing this is about to go. This thing's gonna be glazed like a Krispy Kreme donut, Chad. Okay? And because we greased this pan really good, greased it like we was about to have a fight, baby, like you about to get into a fight. Because you greased it so good with that Baker's Joy or some butter, don't matter. This is how it came out. Beautiful. So we need to let this cool for just a minute or so, maybe about 30 minutes, I would say, and then we're gonna glaze it. Now, if you like to eat your pound cake hot, honey, you go ahead and glaze it and cut right on into it. But I wanna make sure mine is, you know, cool or at least slightly cool before I glaze it on up. Glaze, so we're gonna glaze. Really look pretty on there and all that good stuff. Now, you don't have to use a glaze. This cake is delicious just the way it is. This cake right here is gonna make you slap your mama no matter what. Okay, if you put the glaze on, if you don't put the glaze on. But I just found like putting that glaze on there is making that flavor socked up in there. Okay, so I feel like a glaze take this over the top and makes it just amazing and wonderful and delicious. And if you really try to impress the people, honey, you need that glaze, all right?
I feel like, you know, my food is like this. Since I was raised in a juke joint and my mama was a Sunday school teacher, and since I love Jesus and the juke joint still run in me, so I still love a little whiskey, I would say this. I make food that can help suck up that liquor when you drinking and partying and have a good time, just like they did it in the juke joint, in my daddy's juke joint. But I also make food that'll help suck up that liquor and get you to church in the morning.
Glaze the cake up, y'all. I just like to take a whisk and I just like to drizzle it on there just like that. This allows me to control the glaze a little bit more. And so we're just gonna put it on there just like that. You don't need a whole lot of glaze because remember we got the brownie in there and all that. And actually this glaze is not really sweet. So I love that about it. And honey, we're just gonna glaze this thing up just like that. You see that? Cut into this, y'all. Ooh, yes, Jesus loves me. Ooh, look at that. There we go. Ta-da! Oh my goodness. Now, you know I got to taste it and make sure it's good, because you got to always taste your stuff and make sure it's good before you serve it to the people. And if it's nasty, then you get a chance. That'll give you a chance to throw it out and go buy some Popeye's chicken or some Church's chicken or something. Be like, girl, I just didn't feel like cooking. Or something just happened. Give you a chance to lie. Always taste it before you serve it, okay? All right. Mmm. You know, I know I'm supposed to be right here telling you guys all this stuff to do, like, share, subscribe, and all that, but y'all, this was so good, I don't even know, I can't say nothing else, but y'all know what to do, y'all know.